The lunar economy is nothing else than an extension of a terrestrial economy to the cislunar space, moon, in future may open new market opportunities, but we need to keep in mind all the economic activities and the jobs are still on Earth.
Commercialism of space, a lunar economy, inevitably means space competition, doesn't it? Is that a good thing for driving space exploration?
In exploration, we always need both cooperation and competition. Without competition, we don't drive innovation. We need cooperation between international partners, but we also need industry-to-industry cooperation beyond national boundaries to ensure that we have the end-to-end supply chains we need for future space exploration. But without competition, there is no innovation for space exploration.
And what sort of commercial partnerships is the European Space Agency interested in going forward?
We are interested in any commercial partnership which is founded on a solid business case. Actually, we are listening to the European space industry. They're making proposals to us, and we do assess those proposals. Currently, when it comes to the moon, we're working on three topics. We're trying to assess whether we can commercially establish a service for lunar communication navigation, which is very important to connect the Earth more closely with the moon. We are working on the production of a fuel which will in future be used for radioisotopic devices which power future lunar assets and support the thermal control. But we also try to see how we can position European industry in the value chain of future transportation services, delivering science, cargo and technology to the lunar surface.
So which sort of industries do you think are likely to benefit the most from a lunar economy? I'm thinking satellite communications, perhaps, navigation infrastructures.
Well, of course, there's a classical space industry, building habitats and transportation system. They benefit first. The classical industry providing communication navigation service on Earth can extend their business into deep space. That's clearly a strong business opportunity. And I think a strong business opportunity is everything related to the use of space resources. And here I talk about the mining industry, robotics, industrial processing, and artificial intelligence. So there are lots of industries which are today grounded in a terrestrial sector, which may discover opportunities once we start permanent operation on the lunar surface.
Can you name one, then, Bernard, one major advantage we'll feel the effects of the benefit of down here on Earth from what is going on up there in the sky?
Well, firstly, there's an economic benefit. It's innovation, technology innovation, jobs on Earth. But honestly, ultimately, exploration of space is an inspiration for our society. In particular, in a crisis like this, we know our future is grounded in science and technology. And space exploration is a clear symbol of what we can achieve if we focus on science, technology and innovation.
As you know, we're approaching a green year, 2021. Lots of hopes that we'll have a greener and a safer economy and perhaps a reduction of climate change. A lot of efforts going into that. What about sustainability in lunar terms? Is that important?
Sustainability is important. Without sustainable exploration, we will never create an economy. It's maybe an interesting idea. Whenever we start operating on the moon, we need to create a carbon-free economy because there's no carbon to burn. So we will need to find new technology solutions to sustain human robotic operation on the moon, which also create linkages to addressing climate change topics here on Earth.
Bernard Hoffenbach from the European Space Agency, thanks for joining us on The Agenda.
You're most welcome. Thank you for the opportunity.